Hello, and thank you for joining me on December 21st, 2012, or as the Mayans like to call it, the 13th Baktun. I'm making this video today to celebrate the fact that we're all still alive, that the world did not come to an end, that it was just a bunch of baloney. All the planets being in alignment, the magnetic fields and so forth, all the rumors we've heard are untrue. And to celebrate, I've decided to try Dos Equis. And I've heard it's pretty good. You know, the most interesting man in the world can't be wrong. So we'll go ahead and sample that today. Celebrate the Mayans. I'm going to talk a little bit about who the Mayans are. They actually were native to the Mexican region about 2,000 years ago. They were there before the Spanish conquered that area, and they were very superstitious people. You know, they didn't embrace science. They thought that God was responsible for everything that happened to them, good or bad. And so they made ritualistic sacrifices to God in order to please him. They also were into body piercing and tattooing and a whole bunch of other stuff. It's really interesting. They're really an interesting culture. I would like to take a second here and look at it. So let's see if there's anything interesting about who they were. Seems they were pretty intelligent though for not embracing science. It looks like they did a little bit. Even though they're very superstitious people, God-fearing people, it looks like they were really good at math and writing, and they even studied the stars. Of course, the most important thing about the Mayans was the calendar that they wrote and developed. Like the Aztec and Inca who came to power later, the Maya believed in a cyclical nature of time. The rituals and ceremonies were very closely associated with celestial and terrestrial cycles, which they observed and inscribed as separate calendars. The Maya priest had the job of interpreting these cycles and giving a prophetic outlook on the future or past based on the number of relations of all their calendars. They also had to determine if the heavens were propitious for performing certain religious ceremonies. The Mayans practiced human sacrifice. See, I was right about that. In some Maya rituals, people were killed by having their arms and legs held while a priest cut the person's chest open and tore out his heart as an offering. That is brutal. Brutal. Now, this depicted on ancient objects such as pictorial text known as codices. Much of the Maya religious tradition is still not understood by scholars, but it is known that the Maya believed that the cosmos had three major planes, the earth, the underworld beneath, and the heavens above. The Maya underworld is reached through caves and deep tunnels. It was thought to be dominated by the aged Maya gods of death and putrefaction. It says the life cycle of maize, which is corn, lies at the heart of Maya belief. This philosophy is demonstrated on the belief of the Maya maize god as a central religious figure. The Maya bodily ideal is also based on the form of this young deity, which is demonstrated in their artwork. The maize god was also a model of courtly life for the classical Maya. In the 19th century, Maya culture influenced the local forms of Christianity followed in Chan Santa Cruz. Now, it's really kind of, there's a lot of stuff going on. Okay, there were people who existed, and so for like the last year or so, we've been afraid that today would be the end of the world. I've come to find out that that's not what really they believed. You see, they thought that everything is a cycle. That means there's a beginning and an end and another beginning, and it just continues on and on. Anyway, without any further ado, I just wanted to give a little background about who the Mayans were. And it's really interesting. So the Mayans, they're Mexicans before the Spanish was there, so they make some Mexicans, native Mexicans. And so now we're gonna try Dos Equis. Now I can try to imitate the most interesting guy, can I? So I can do his accent. Dos Equis. I don't always drink beer. When I do, I prefer Dos Equis. Stay thirsty, my friends. Pressurized. Alright, so is it good? Let's find out. You know, I've had Corona before, and it always leaves this kind of this bitter, sour aftertaste. I have to say that this Dos Equis is really smooth. Kind of reminds me of Corona. It has that Corona taste. I don't know, perhaps all Mexican beers have that flavor, but it's not very strong at all. It's real mild. So I'm gonna drink this whole can if I can. It's good. Yeah, you know, I've got these prime time little cigars. See, I'm glad it's not the end of the world. That's another thing that's real smooth. These prime times, there's hardly any bite to them. You can breathe it, inhale it, blow it out. Is it burning your throat? You know, it's watermelon. Why do I say vanilla? Probably because I've been up all night. I'm really tired. I just got off work. But I wanted to celebrate the end of the world. So we have Dos Equis imported from Mexico, because of course the Mayans are Mexican. Of recent events. I mean, I know what you're thinking. What right do I have to enjoy myself today after everything that's gone on? And this is just my way of saying that even though what happened was tragic and unspeakable, try not to succumb to depression. Try to find some way to enjoy life. Try to find peace. I'm not sure what people are going to get out of this video. We might turn it off after a few seconds. I'm going to try to drink this whole thing. The Mayans. They performed a lot of human sacrifices. I was reading it. Watching a documentary, and they had this ocean, this water, killing them, ripping their hearts out, and so forth. They dump the bodies in the water, and people recently, explorers of diving, went down there and found skulls and remains, and they weren't very picky about who they sacrificed. They sacrificed adults, children, men, women, it didn't really matter. All that mattered was pleasing their gods. And I gotta say, the maize god, being the god of corn, I mean, is that really something that's cool? Like, hey, I'm the god of corn. I know how to make corn. I'm the god of corn. You know, you have other gods like Zeus, the god of thunder. You know, I mean, do they like laugh at each other? Like, I'm the god of lightning and thunder. I'm the god of love. I'm the god of corn. But, you know, the Mayans liked him. I don't mean to offend. That's really a big god. And it's like, I hope it's not like making fun of Muhammad, because I don't want to get my head cut off. But, so the Mayans, pretty hardcore. But, cool people though. Wonder how many people committed suicide. You know, they thought the end of the world was coming, so they just decided, screw it, I'm out of here, you know. Oops. I didn't mean to swallow that smoke. Oh, I swallowed it. Oh my god. So the Mayans were big on religion. They had lots of different gods. They all pretty much got along. Believed in human ritualistic sacrifice. Wow. Dos Equis. What if today really was the end of the world? And we're not even alive right now. We're all in Mayan hell. What do we even know? We're gone. So, let me read about this. It says, so it's a 24-ounce Dos Equis, crafted in Mexico since 1897 to commemorate the arrival of the 20th century. So, two X's. That's what it means. The two X's, that's for the night, for the 20th century, I suppose. Alright guys, so let's be honest. Tell me, how many of you sold everything you own, put everything on the auction block, because you're afraid of the end of the world? You bought into it, you believed it hook, line, and sinker, and so you sold everything you own. And now you're left with nothing. I just lost it there, folks. See, I'm not usually a drinker. I don't know. It's starting to knock me on my ass. This kind of kills two birds with one stone. I like to honor the Mayans, to remember them. And to kind of flip them off, like, yeah, you know, I'm still here. You failed, you've lied. It's not the end of the world.
No.
It says here that Dos Equis is a larger lager that was originally brewed by the German-born Mexican brewer. Wow. Are you kidding me? This isn't even Mexican beer, it's German. A German guy went to Mexico. His name was Wilhelm Hasse, that's how I pronounced it. The brand was named Singulo XX, 20th century, to commemorate the arrival of the new century, and the bottle remarked the Roman numeral 20XX, Dos Equis, which is Spanish for 2X's. The main brand Dos Equis special lager is a 4.45 ABV pale lager, sold in green bottles. Dos Equis XX Amber is 4.7. Well. Oh man. So it turns out that Dos Equis, no wonder it tastes so mild. 4.7% alcohol. Wow. I was kind of hoping to get fucked up. So. Dos Equis will not do the job. It will not get you drunk. Didn't know that. So it looks like we might just have to back up our Dos Equis with a little rum. Good old demon rum, huh? Alright. Well, I ran out of things to talk about. They're cool. They're hardcore. Don't fuck with them. You know? And whatever you do, don't steal their corn. They will fuck you. They will track you down. They will fuck you. They'll rip your heart out. Well, there it goes. That's 24 ounces of Dos Equis. Down the hatch. Commemorating the 20th century. You know, I have a question about that. This was made to commemorate the 20th century. Are they going to make a beer to commemorate the 21st century? Call it Tres Equis or something. It doesn't have quite the same ring to it. I wonder if they'll still use the same guy. I don't know if I drink beer, but when I do, I drink Tres Equis. I don't know. But we're gonna keep this party going. We're gonna celebrate the Mayans. Okay? To the Mayans. You goofy bastards. I love you. Now that's better. That's 35% alcohol. That's 70 proof. See, 35%, 4.5%. 35, 4.5. Is there any question about which is the better here? Although this is the Dos Equis testimonial. It was good. I recommend it. It's a nice lager, it tastes good. Finishes well. But it's not gonna get you too much drunk, I don't think. You know? Go Captain Morgan. He'll stir shit up. He always does. He'll just fuck everything up. Start breaking windows and shit. Alright, so if Captain Morgan can do it, we have other choices. We've got Crown Royale. I keep calling it Crown Royale. Why do I keep doing that? It's Crown Royal. Look at this. Good shit right here. To the Mayans. To the Mayans. Started with Dos Equis, but I feel just pretty damn good. I don't really feel like stopping. I feel like just celebrating the shit out of this end of the world apocalypse, even though it's not really supposed to be the end of the world. They just believed it was the end of something and the beginning of something else, another cycle. God bless them. That's some potent shit right there. That is strong. That'll put hair on your chest. I haven't done this. I haven't drank for a long time, but it's the end of the world. We can celebrate that. I'll drink to the end of the world. And I'm kind of surprised that we're still here, that the Mayan calendar didn't kill us all, that the asteroid didn't crash into Earth, or whatever was supposed to happen. All the planets and all the planets are lined up. But, yeah. Nothing cool like that ever happened. One more left. One more liquor. Whoa, oh shit. Oh, it's all fun and games now. Until someone brings out the fireball. You know, I've had this since the 4th of July. Yeah, this is all I drink out of it. It's just a little bit. See, I'm not much of a drinker. It smells just like cinnamon, you know? Have you ever, had a cinnamon gummy bear? It smells just like that. It's called cinnamon whiskey. Cinnamon whiskey. Yeah, it's some pretty good stuff right here. Alright, man, let's just have it a shot. Boy, yeah. It's a lot easier to take down than the other stuff, the bourbon I just had. Well, let's bring out the family. Dos Equis. Captain Morgan. And... Grand Royale. Go party at my place. Mayans can come. Other people can come too. I'm feeling pretty good now. I'm feeling kind of hot. It's like whatever the temperature is in here, we just went up like probably 100 degrees. I'm just glad that the world isn't over yet. We get to still do fun things. Get to drink Dos Equis. That was pretty good. I liked it. And I have to say it hit the spot. But it's not as potent as I would have liked. I think now is a good time to quit drinking. I'm starting to burp. I'm starting to feel like I'm gonna throw up, you know? So this is the first time I ever drank beer on YouTube. And from what I understand, it's okay. It doesn't violate their guidelines or anything. Because we have a little something called Epic Meal Time, and they get drunk all the time. They get drunk worse than I do. And they cook. They make good food. I don't even know where my kitchen is right now. I'm very glad that the Mayan Indian calendar was wrong, that we still have a chance to live life to the fullest and celebrate. Bye, America. Let this be a lesson. Don't believe everything you read or hear on TV. If someone says the end of the world is coming up, don't believe them. Don't sell your stuff. Don't convert to some wackadoo religion. Go away with some crazy cult that wants to take all your money and your house and possessions, leave you high and dry. Don't do that. And don't drink the Kool-Aid. If you see people passing out, you stay away from that shit. You get the hell out of there. Okay? Life is too precious to throw away. Remember that. Oh shit. I think I drank too much. So, now the trick is just to get off the chair and into. Dos Equis. Good stuff. Oh my god, it's good. I recommend it. But you know, you probably shouldn't drink too much hard liquor. It kind of screws things up. But it's okay. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna try to go to bed. Okay? You get to be on YouTube after all. Muffin! Oh, hi, Muffins. Yes! I'm glad it's not the end of the world. Muffin and I are happy that the Mayans were wrong. Oh yes, the Mayans were wrong. Oh, kiki kiki. Oh, kiki. Merry Christmas. Muffin. Oh yes, the Mayans were wrong. Oh. Bye, everybody.